six runs and take a 10-5 lead. It'll be Aaron Wilkerson, no record, a 3.18 ERA, getting some extra work in here in a relief role as he tries to protect this five-run lead. Back on the call for the rest of regulation, here's Dan Carter.
Okay, let's hope that's all we have left in this one. Sky Sox have opened it up just a bit here. The Redbirds lead in this one. First pitch is a strike on the outside corner. Six-run. Seventh inning. Did the trick. Sky Sox lead by five. The next delivery is a breaking ball in the dirt. Ball one, a ball and a strike. Garcia tonight, 1-for-3 with a single. He'll be followed by the catcher, Andrew Kisner. And then the pitcher's spot, 1-1 pitch, popped him up outside of first. Over is Moore. Appears to have a little bit of room, reaching, but cannot make the play. The ball lands in the walkway leading to the Sky Sox clubhouse. You cannot cross over that line over there to make a play. You're out of bounds if you do. And so Moore knew that he could not go any further. And the count is 1-2 to Garcia. Right-handed batting right fielder. 10 runs, 14 hits, 2 errors for the Sox. 5 runs, 8 hits, 3 errors for Memphis. Neither team playing a real clean game defensively. Here's the 1-2 offering from Wilkerson, and the breaking ball is outside. Perhaps a little bit of a hangover from having the day off yesterday. The Redbirds traveled today, so they had a long day of travel. Line drive caught by the shortstop Orff, and right to him by Garcia, one down in the eighth. That'll bring Andrew Kisner to the plate. Sox will be in Memphis just a few days. Check out the Memphis Downtown Sheraton Hotel, located right near all the action. Beale Street, AutoZone Ballpark, within walking distance. Here's the pitch, righty-righty. Breaking ball just outside, 1-0. Kisner is 1-for-3 with a double in his AAA debut. Wilkerson kicks and deals. This is lifted to left center field, playable for Broxton. Center fielder under it, puts it away, two down. Kisner skies to center, and now a pinch hitter for the Redbirds. It's going to be Alex Mejia to bat for Edward Mojica. Mejia, infielder, right-handed batter. And the pitch to him from Wilkerson is in there for a strike. Mejia comes in hitting 271, a home run and 5 RBIs. Wilkerson's only other appearance was a start against Oklahoma City. Strike called and the count is 0-2. Decision, went 5 2/3, 2 runs, 6 hits, no walks, 6 strikeouts. Here he comes, 2 strike delivery. Outside with a fastball, 1-2. Finishing that thought on the downtown Memphis Sheraton, check him out online. It's a beautiful hotel overlooking the mighty Mississippi. 1-2 pitch, breaking ball in the dirt, 2-2, or at least low. There. Definitely down there near all the action. Beale Street, AutoZone Ballpark, have a trolley that will take you to those major attractions. The pitch is peppered foul to the right side, out of play. Count remains even at 2-2 to the pinch hitter, Mejia. So check them out online, Sheraton Memphis Downtown Hotel, or call them at 901-527-7300. 10-5, Sky Sox lead here in the eighth. Wilkerson brings it home. Breaking ball is fouled back out of play. Wilkerson is slated to start the finale on Sunday. So this is like getting some work in between starts for him. Into his windup, the 2-2 offering. Fouled back yet again by Mejia. Seventh pitch of the plate appearance. Rockies are in San Francisco, and they lead 3-1 in the fourth inning. with Chad Bettis on the mound. Brewers are idle. Pitch is high, and the count is now full 3-2 on deck. The top of the lineup, Oscar Mercado. Parent team for the Redbirds, the Cardinals at home. Knocked off by the Phillies, 6-2. Pitch is spoiled again by Mejia. So this will at least be a 10-pitch at bat before it's all said and done. Count remains full at 3-2 to the pinch hitter, Alex Mejia. Facing right-hander Aaron Wilkerson, so righty-righty here. And the 3-2 pitch on the way, lifted down the right field line. In pursuit is Phillips, and slicing, that ball will be to the deck and then off the deck. That houses the hot tub heaven out there. 10 pitches in, the count remains full, 3-2 to Mejia. Field playing him to hit the other way, the pitch, and it's laced into center field, a base hit. Talk about earning that hit. 11 pitch at bat for Mejia, and he singles with two down here in the eighth. And back on top to Oscar Mercado. Mercado 2-for-3 with a walk. 10-5 Sky Sox. That's the ninth hit of the game for the Redbirds, and they've continued that trend of getting at least one hit in every inning of this game. The trail by five big ones. And one hit exactly in each of the first six innings. Two hits in the seventh, and now one here in the eighth. Another righty-righty matchup. Mercado takes outside 1-0. The Phillies continue to play well. They defeat the Cardinals today. Spritz by Wilkerson. The pitch on the way is just outside ball 2-0. Coming in today, the Phillies a game back of the Braves in the National League East. While the Cardinals are a game back of the Pirates and the Brewers in the NL Central. Pirates win at home against San Diego. 2-0 pitch way outside ball 3. So the Pirates take over first place in the National League Central, half game over the Brewers. Two up on the Cardinals. 3-0 pitch, taken all the way for a strike, 3-1. Cubs and the Braves were postponed, so the Cubs now 2.5 games up. Four teams right now battling for that division lead. Pitch is high ball 4. 2-on-2 outs for the Redbirds. Max Schrock is coming up, and out of the first base dugout is manager Rick Sweet. Aaron Wilkerson has reached his pitch limit here. Again, just working in between starts here, so they don't want him to get overtaxed. And the Sky Sox will call upon left-hander Mike Zagurski with a 5-run lead here in the top of the eighth inning. Pitching change here at Security Service Field. Sky Sox lead Memphis 10-5. Back with more right after this on Extra Sports 1300.